एन के प्रेमचंदन।
थैंक यू वेरी मच स्पीकर सर। सर आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ माय पार्टी रेवोल्यूशनरी सोशलिस्ट पार्टी आरएसपी एक्सटेंड हार्टी कंग्रेचुलेशंस इन अज्यूमिंग द हाईएस्ट ऑफिस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी दैट टू इन द लार्जेस्ट डेमोक्रेसी इन द वर्ल्ड। सर यू आर एक्सपीरियंस 30 इयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इन पार्लियामेंट एंड द लेजिस्लेचर that is in Rajasthan state legislative assembly as well as 3 terms in parliament and also 5 years as the speaker of this house. Definitely I believe that, firmly believe that the expertise leadership will give fruitful results to the 18th Lok Sabha in running the house. Sir, I would like to say some quotations. The Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, sir, it is a famous quotation that the speaker, the symbol of nation's freedom and liberty. Sir, Kowland sector refer the speaker as the conscious and guardian of the house. Sir, I would like to refer the speaker is the soul and spirit of Indian democracy and the custodian of the house. And further, I would like to say that while the government has its way in the house, it is incumbent upon the speaker to ensure that the opposition has its full say. Sir, I would like to urge upon the honorable speaker, sir, the opposition's legitimate demands and rights of the opposition has to be protected so as to have a healthy democratic practice in our country. Sir, one more point I would like to make. Sir, the independence of the parliament has to be protected at any cost. Why I am saying this is, sir, we know that the separation of powers, judiciary, executive and legislature is the essential ingredients, basic character of the constitution. That okay. Sir, one historic example I would like to say. In 1647, the King Charles I entered into the House of Commons and demanded the relieving of 5 MPs from the House as they are guilty of treason. And what the then Speaker, William Lenthal, he was the Speaker of the House of Commons, what he said, I would like to quote and I will end. Sir, I would like to quote, "May it please your majesty, I have neither eyes to see nor tongue to speak in this place, but as the House is pleased to direct me, whose servant I am here. And I humbly majesty your pardon that I cannot give any other answer than this to what your majesty is pleased to," unquote. Sir, the Speaker of the House in 1647 not even succumbed to the pressure of the King Charles I, who has never cared of the parliament. Sir, I hope and believe that your expertise experience can bring back the glory of our parliament, the traditions and customs, and thereby protect the independence of the parliament. And once again, I extend my hearty congratulations in assuming the post of the speaker after Balram Jakarji for the consecutive 2 times. Thank you very much, sir.
Very good.
सदन का अच्छा दिन है पप्पू जी, बार बार मत उठा करो। आप सीनियर मेंबर हैं। मैं माननीय सदस्यों सबसे आग्रह करना चाहता हूँ, आज एक अच्छा दिन है, आप अपनी बात संक्षिप्त में कह दें, जो कुछ भी पॉलिटिकल बात कहनी है आपको राष्ट्रपति अभिभाषण में पर्याप्त समय, पर्याप्त अवसर मिलेगा।